hot and stormy weather forecast for southeastern Australia over the next 48 hours, with severe thunderstorms possible and high to extreme fire danger. Looking at the satellite picture, we can see moisture being dragged down from the tropics and wrapping into this low pressure system in the Bight, giving us showers and thunderstorms over southeastern parts of South Australia, and this weather system will move east over the next couple of days. Looking at the thunderstorm picture for today, these green areas are where thunderstorms are possible, but the yellow areas are where severe thunderstorms are possible. So over eastern parts of Victoria, we could see severe thunderstorms produce heavy rainfall that could lead to flash flooding. But over the border of Victoria and South Australia, we could see severe thunderstorms produce heavy rainfall, but also damaging wind gusts in excess of 90 kilometres an hour. However, tomorrow is when we see most of the thunderstorm activity widespread across the southeast, with the severe thunderstorms possible through southern parts of New South Wales, most of Victoria, and into northern Tasmania. Through northern Tasmania, the risk is mostly for heavy rainfall that could lead to flash flooding. But over Victoria and New South Wales, we have the risk of supercell thunderstorms producing heavy rainfall, damaging wind gusts, and large hail. Now, this red area is where severe thunderstorms are likely, and there is also a slight risk in this area of destructive wind gusts up to 120 kilometres an hour. We also have high pollen across Victoria tomorrow, so we do have a thunderstorm asthma risk across the state. However, the highest risk area is through central areas from about Colac through to Sale. Looking at the synoptic pattern, we can see that we have the low pressure system in the Bight, this trough extending down. Now this trough is giving us showers and thunderstorms, and we will see those extend across as the trough moves through. But also ahead of it, we do have this northerly to northeasterly flow, which is hot and humid, also good weather for thunderstorms. So most of the thunderstorm activity happening on or ahead of that front. And as it moves through, this will become our cool change. So we'll see much cooler west to southwesterly winds behind that trough as it moves through, and the low pressure system moves away to the south. So looking at the heat today, we can see temperatures up into the 40s in inland parts, quite hot through the eastern parts of the country, up to 10 degrees above average for December. Tomorrow, hot once again, although we can see the cool change starting to push into the southwest parts of Victoria. Still 30 degrees for Hobart and Launceston, 33 in Melbourne. But on Thursday, as that cool change has pushed through, the heat mostly contracting to New South Wales, in particular along the coast, where we could see in Sydney 36 degrees and in Penrith up to 40 degrees possible. All that heat gives us increased fire danger. So for today, high fire danger through much of the southeast. But tomorrow is when the winds really pick up and we see extreme fire dangers. So this is in the Murraylands and Riverlands parts of South Australia, the southwest and northern Riverina districts in New South Wales, and the Mallee and Wimmera in Victoria. This is where fire danger is extreme, and any fires that start will be very hard to put out. So please take care and take precautions. On Thursday, as the cool change moves through, we see the high fire danger area extending into New South Wales. So even though most of the focus is on the cyclone up north, there's a lot of weather coming for southeastern Australia over the next 48 hours. So please stay up to date with the forecasts and warnings on the Bureau's app or at our website. Follow all advice from emergency services, and please stay safe.